Music is a means of influencing the consciousness. So many different types of music, and we see that they affect us. In supermarkets, some nice light music is there. The plane is landing, relaxing music, whatever kinds of music are there, and they all affect our consciousness. I also, in the 60s, experimented with music in so many ways, lying between two speakers and sort of letting it take me away. What has interested me for a long time is the sacred in music. Because I found that music can lift us up above the reality of every day and nourish us, and then we return with new energy into that everyday environment. And well, I come from a background where there was, it was the fast life in the fast lane in the city with lots of loans from the bank and a lot of pressure to pay it off. That wasn't me, that was my family. And with that, things were stressful. But I had music. I was singing, I was playing different instruments, and that created some serenity in my life, some shell where I could rejuvenate. And so one day I realized it's not just a peaceful thing I'm looking for something sublime. And eventually I realized it's something sacred that I look for. And so eventually I came to Kirtan, because that is what Kirtan is all about. It is sacred sound. And that sacred sound is lifting up the consciousness. And whether we are, whether we are actively aware of that and consciously trying to elevate ourselves, or whether we're not aware of that, doesn't make any difference. The mantra itself, the kirtan itself, uplifts the consciousness. So that's our first aim this evening, to rise above the modes of nature. The material energy has different modes of nature. Goodness is which is nourishing. Passion is which is exciting, but also leaves us drained. Ignorant is draining all the way, and just leaves us quite destroyed. So, goodness or transcendence is what we are into. And Kirtan will bring that. So let us begin there. Let us begin and invoke some atmosphere of goodness and then go to the transcendental platform.
Shakshurminitamyena tasmai shri gurave namah. Shri Chaitanya manabhisram sarpitanyena bhutale svayam rupa kadamayam dadati svaparantikam. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadha Sri Vasudhi Gaura Bhaktivedanta Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare.
Bye. Yeah. Hare
purpose.
Thank you. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Rama Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Everyone is an individual. Everyone has a different nature. Some are cool, some are hot. And some are combination. Like different colors. Yellow, blue, red can make endless combinations. So in the same way, the soul picks up a different consciousness at a different time, like the wind blowing over a field of roses, carrying the scent of those roses with it for a long distance. The wind from the ocean carries the freshness of the salt water.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. Thank you. Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Krishna, Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare
Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. Thank you.
So everywhere we see energy, it is a world of energy. And there are many energies, energy within us and energy without us. We can generate energy ourselves also, according to the energy that we have. We can make waves. We can make sound waves also. And we think an endless stream of thoughts, never ending. Never a time that we don't think of something. The train of thought takes us from one step to another, from one thing to another. Travel. Plane, train, car, travel, boat, travel. Where? Country? Colombia. Oh, Colombia. Nice mangoes in Colombia. Did you know that? Yeah? Good fruits, Colombia. Some other things also that we don't talk about today. No. Let's go somewhere else. New York City. Okay, move. Time to go. Yes, move. New York City. Train, subway, go down, deep down in dungeons, go through turnstiles, get in, get your coin, get moving. Doors closing, stay clear of the door, move, yes. New York City, no end in all directions. New York City. Let's go somewhere else. Beach. Quiet beach. Southern Greece. Crete. Oh yes, nice beach. Grapes. Lots of them growing everywhere. Ooh. Just grapes. Grapes. Lots of grapes. Oranges also. Bread. Lots of bread. Hot. In the morning. Beach. People living there in the winter. Some in the caves, some on the sand. Matala has the caves, yes. South of Crete. But why are these people beating the octopuses on the rocks? They go catch them, and for hours they beat them on stone. It's just disturbing my peaceful beach. Go away, please. We want quiet. We want goodness, no violence. All right. Then where? Delhi. Oh, Delhi. Oh, so much smoke. Oh, Delhi. So much noise. Oh, Delhi. I gotta get out of here quick. A place to land, a place to pass through, but no place to stay, nor go away from Delhi. Too big. Heli Delhi. Let's move. Then the villages in India. Ah, more interesting. Ah. Cows. Rivers. People are going to the rivers. The well. Women carrying pots on their heads and pulling water from the well. That looks good and honest. It looks like it's supposed to be better than a machine, better than a plastic bottle, better than all these artificial things. The roots, back to the roots, back to our true nature, back to who we are, back to what? But yes, in search of ourselves. Here, looking there, and each place is like a mirror, and in each place we see what we could be and what we are, and thus everywhere. And we meet people, And in relationships with these people, we see ourselves more than ever. And if we don't see, they will see, and they will say, and we will find that we change. But not really. Deep down, we don't change at all. Deep down, still the same. Years go by. Fade. Skin dries up. It sags in all directions. Hairs start growing where they really shouldn't be. And what can I say? Eyesight going. Teeth getting loose. Oh God, liver cannot take it anymore. Time, gray, drab. No, wisdom. Sages, ancient sages in holy places, deeply absorbed, away from hustle and bustle, not affected by all these things, but deeper absorbed in real meaning of life. They've thought about it, what to do, what not to do. Huh. That's the question, what to do? What to do? What to do? Oh, have you asked the question? So many situations. What to do? Nothing going on. What to do? Too much going on. What to do? What to do? Philosophers have thought. But did it bring solutions or confusion? Confucius? Why does he have that name? Have you thought about it? Funny. For a man who's looking for answers and he's known in the world as Confucius. Interesting. Well, fusion instead of confusion, then let's all get together, mix it all into one big mix, culture mix, call it Australia, and just be here. Somehow or other, it's all right, man. No worries. But is it true? Then why are the lights in the toilets in the Sydney railway station that white light where you can't see your veins? Why? Why is that? Do you know? I'm from Amsterdam, I know. What can I say? Yes, I know very well. Again, go somewhere else. Again, on the move. Change situation. Yes, change, change, change. Change job. Change your hair. Change something. Different contact lenses, different color eyes. And you see the world totally different, and the world sees you different. But is it really a change or just cosmetic changes? Who are we? Who are we really? That is the question. That is our deeper question. Will philosophy bring the answer? Philosophy raises the questions. But philosophy, when man is climbing a mental ladder, going up and up, logically, systematically, and defining what is and what is not. But how do you know? Can we know? Can we know what is the universe? Do we really know what's on Mars? Have you been there? I mean, has anybody really been there? Or are they saying, did they really go and all that? I mean, how do you know? Gosh, do you believe Trump? I don't know. I mean, or any of those of his colleagues in other countries? I don't know. Can you really trust all those peoples whose faces are printed on money? I don't know. Do you trust those faces? I don't know. Do you trust in money? I don't know, gosh, so many questions, too complicated. Right, yes, but we think, thinking, 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 lots of thinking. Good thinking, but other answers. Then someone stops me in the street and says, do you know that Jesus is reborn? I say, yes, I know. He became a Hare Krishna. Yes, what can I say? I heard about that. Yes, what to do? Oh, so many. Some people are so sure they have the answers, but are they happy? If you have the answers, then you have to show a path of greater happiness. So philosophy is good, because philosophy, thinking is needed. You cannot just, you know, walk through the streets like a dodo. No, not thinking, no brainer. Just automatic pilot, or zombie, right. That is not useful. What will you gain with all these things? No, it must be conscious living, choices, make choices. No. Choices that will benefit not only ourselves, but everyone. Imagine we would be a person who would be beneficial in all directions. Imagine we would have positive relationships with everyone. Imagine our presence in the world would be a benediction. Does that describe the President of the United States? Maybe not. So imagine we could be like that. But how? Such a thing can only be when the sacred has been deeply embraced within. Within, yes, then it can be done. So, in search of the sacred, I found sacred sound. I went to India, but didn't really find it. But in Amsterdam, of all places, I found it. I didn't think I would find anything sacred in Amsterdam, you know. But somehow or other, some musician started to sing this mantra, this kirtan. And I played along on a guitar and I sang along. And I knew it was pure. Then in India I also found temples, bells ringing. I was sitting at the bank of the Ganga, and in the darkness of the night, I saw wooden boats pass by, filled with people singing. It sounded serene. It sounded not from this world. Is that river from this world? Is Ganga from this world? That's my question. I sat there with my guitar. I sang. Ever-flowing river. Ever-flowing stream. Descending and giving mercy from the Supreme. I believed it. It was a holy river. There was no doubt about it. All these people there also believed it. I was not alone. Everybody believed it. Everybody who was there believed it. Only the people who were not there didn't believe it. Well, what can you do? Sour grapes? They were missing out. Yes. And then, in this way, impressions, many impressions, and all impressions are coming together and bringing us answers to our questions. Is everything intellectual? Or what about intuition? What about feeling? What about just knowing? What about sensing that it's true? All these things are there. Oh. I went to different places in the Himalayas. I went up on the Himalayas, climbed up and came high up to a little Shiva temple. There was a French girl dressed like Lord Shiva. She had a top knot and everything. But she was laughing when me and my brother were having potatoes to eat. She go, potatoes? But potatoes were good because we would throw them in the ashes and they would just cook in the ashes. It was easy cooking, you know. For bachelors, it's the way to go, guys. Just potatoes, fire, tastes good, you know. Spuds, you know. King of veggies, there you go. Yeah, good on you, mate. Bit of salt, bit of salt. Little butter. I mean, we did well, you know, with our potatoes, I tell you. Oh, well, she had rice. So we had rice and potatoes. But didn't stay with that Shiva lady. No. I thought, no. Not for me. Not what I'm looking for. Looking for something that lasts. Not for some quick exchanges. I moved on. Moved on from place to place, from person to person. Anyway, the kirtan came back again and again. And each time it came, it brought, it was positive. Now the kirtan is there all the time. Now the kirtan has become my anchor. Now the kirtan has gradually penetrated. When I first heard the mantra, I thought it was sacred sound. I thought it was some sort of spiritual energy. But then I realized that it's more than that. I realized that actually, just like I make waves in the ether, just like I make waves in water, just like I make waves in people's hearts, in the same way, someone was behind. I could see behind energy, there is a person. That was interesting. Energy and a person. Oh, both. Yes. Ah, it's been an old debate. Philosophers have argued. It's an all pervading energy, formless. Yes. No, it's a form. It's a personality. Yes. There's no debate. It's both. Did you ever think of that? It's both. Jeez. Gosh. All that arguing for millennia. Millennia, people have been burned, you know. Debates in India, there have been debates, serious, serious debates, and the loser had to sit in a slow burning fire. Or surrender, give up the debate. So it was intense amongst philosophers, but we don't worry. We just take the kirtan and let it do what it does. And whatever it does, it gives us positive strength, strength of mind, strength of character, and gradually philosophical clarity. Then we realize the Absolute is personal, it is also all-pervading energy. All these things, all these features, just as we are persons and just as we have energies. Because the same thing is within us, it is everywhere. Therefore, Kirtan is not only sacred sound, but it is also a deep glorification. Kirti, the Sanskrit word kirti, means glorification. Therefore, kirtan means glorification. Glorification of the divine, of the sacred, which we see everywhere and which we don't see. What we know and what we don't know. I saw the sacred on a plane coming from South Africa to Europe, and just as the morning was about to begin and the first rays of light were above the clouds, an African man walked up to the front of the plane and stood up, raised his arms and made a gesture to turn, like a conductor of an orchestra. And next moment he begins to wave his hands and half the plane starts singing. There was a black gospel choir on the plane. And I tell you, I mean, they are incredible. No instruments, right? But voices, just voices and rhythms, and like, it was just something. And just early in the morning, just as the sun is rising, celestial sound, incredible. And people came out of the business class, and at one point there were three pilots watching, and I was wondering who's flying the plane. Anyway, you know, poor, it was something else. And then there was thunder in the sky that morning from the applause. It was incredible. Everyone was touched. Everyone, you know, they were just like, poor. People were crying, people were just like, it was just incredible. Whoa. Have you seen the sacred? Have you heard it in music? Have you seen it in art? Have you seen it in nature? Have you seen it in the mountains? Have you seen it in the sky? With the light? Have you seen? Everyone can see. Well, of course, people who don't want to see it, see. This is all rubbish. Just, you know, get serious, you know. Go get a job. Okay. That's all right. That's also good. I'm not. But still, there is more. And we see it. We hear it. On that morning on the plane, everybody knew it. Yes. Yes. When I was a kid, where I grew up was not really Amsterdam. It was just outside of Amsterdam in a nice place. You know? And in that place, there was, near to our house, there was a forest, and there were swans. There were swans in a large pond with water lilies. And I would sit and watch these swans, right? And I knew these swans know things. They know something that I don't know. Yes, majestically floating around, very peaceful and calm. Yes. When we were children, we saw the miracle. We saw miracles everywhere. Now, you know, we can explain everything. A swan is just a combination of, like, particular species of bird, you know what I mean? There's, like, there's a whole family of them, you know, and it's like, they live so many years, and they come this size. And if you don't know, you Google it anyway, then, you know, right? See, like, there's no problem at all, right? So we got the answer to all questions, and if any questions you can't answer, you just Google it, and that's it, you know. And Wiki knows everything, right? So what is there, you know, what questions are left? But I think these swans know something that Wiki doesn't know. I think miracles are happening, but we have demystified reality to a point where everything looks ordinary. It's an ordinary Monday, and then it's like, you know, the week is just starting. Where is our sensitivity? But kirtan, somehow or other, opens doors in our consciousness, awakens something within us, and expands our consciousness to look beyond what is just in front of our feet, but to go a bit further and to actually see what are we really part of. And that is what, more or less, this evening is aiming at. It said, different birds fly on different levels in the sky. So in the same way, different individuals are flying on different levels of consciousness in the kirtan. But somehow or other, everyone is elevated. And let us take it to that. And then we do it again. So with that, just for a couple of minutes to close the whole thing, we'll do something. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama
lentement.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Drag the nose.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.
Drag it.
Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
Hare Rama.
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna,
Krishna Krishna,
Hare
Hare, Hare
Rama.
One more time.
Kirtan. Kirtan is so much fun, what can I say? It's hard to stop. But we do it again tomorrow at another place, as we did this morning. And I think yesterday we also did. And before that. Not so long ago as in Mauritius, the band is also pretty much from Mauritius. Sabuch is from Germany, but he's a world traveler. But I was just in Mauritius, and these guys, they are, everyone on the island is a drummer. It's just inconceivable. I mean, these guys, and today I had to hold them down, you know, and it was like, phew. We were on the beach in Mauritius, and it was just, the whole beach was dancing. It was a rocking beach. So maybe we should do that in Bondi one day, in rock Bondi. Whatever. It comes in all styles, meditative, rocking. Once upon a time I used to rock, now. The times have changed. So it was nice. Hope to meet you again. Hope you enjoyed the evening. I think there are some other parts to the program as well. Yeah. Someone will come from somewhere. See? I knew that would happen. And will tell us something more about what's to happen. If you haven't figured it out yet.
Thank you, Kanana Swami, for a wonderful kirtan. Thank you everyone for such an amazing participation. So the session ends with a dinner that will be served right wherever you are. Make yourself comfortable and the guys will bring out the dinner for you. Thank you. And by the way, there are some books and CDs by Kadamba Swami about kirtan and meditation. The book is on meditate different. It's for $10 donation and the CDs for $20 donation. And it helps him to travel around the world and spread this amazing art of kirtan.
You can keep. And if you don't have that much, you give a bit less and it's okay.
Thank you.
But if you want to give more, that's also okay. Whatever you can. Shall we stop? The cute on the neck.
Face like
this. Who does?